Right, hello folks. Gordon at Hopeful as well with you. It's live painting series 2. I thought I'd do another stab at live painting. I'm not sure. I've heard a lot of chatter in the internet marketing circles, the social media circles, that Facebook isn't even promoting live videos at the moment. A good thing about live videos is that when you do a live video, finish it and then download it afterwards so you can post it on other channels. That's the good bit. The good bit used to be of live videos as well is that it used to push live videos out to sort of followers and friends. If it's not doing that anymore, there's not much point in doing a live video unless you're doing it at specific sessions and you advertise it in advance, which doesn't really work for me at the moment because I paint by natural light. So it's Sunday afternoon, February the 18th, 2024. The light is good. Well, it was, but of course the sun has just found a cloud as soon as I hit the record button. So the light isn't great now. And this is one of those canvases. You probably can't see it on this video, but there's a yellow brown blob there and one there as well. This is from that pack of two packs of canvases that I had to get refunded from Arteza, which they did refund and said I could have the canvases anyway. So I'm hoping to be able to paint over that one. Now, I did say in the last painting series that this time I was going to try and do one that I could finish all in one go. And I'm going to try and do a swirl painting. That was the first one I did. Oh, sort of universe-y. Then I did an autumn one. And then I did one in my sort of reverse Eric Morcan rainbow colour scheme. I thought I should get these done in all in one go, but I'm not sure I am going to, because there's something else I want to add on to it this time. I want to add something over the top of the finished version, so we'll see how it goes. I don't think I'm going to get it all in one go. Plus, as usual, I've spent a lot of time waffling. Now, those previous ones I just showed you, I did the swirls pretty much straight on the canvas. But this time, I'm going to put a paint underbase on, which again is going to slow down the process. Want a lot of light blue in there. Mustn't put too much on, because I must remember that this is just an underpaint, so that underneath the actual painting it's not blank canvas, because the stuff that I'm put on top will have gaps in it. So I don't want blank canvas. I can have blank canvas underneath, it's not the end of the world by any stretch of the imagination. But if you put paint underneath it, then you won't have blank canvas. So the problem is taken away. Bit of white. Now, should I put the next colour on as well, or should I get this lot painted first? Well, I know the answer to that, because I've just got a lot of paint all over my fingers, which I don't normally do. So I'm going to do these bits first. Right, shall I stand up?
Yeah.
How are we doing? Okay. Right to the edge with that, and go right to the edge with it over here as well. So I'm already getting coverage right up to the masking tape. What I want. Okay, that'll do for that. Oh yeah, I'm definitely not going to get this done in one go, am I? Now, had that just been palette knife over the top, you can see why palette knife over the top of blank canvas and then no embellishment over the top. I could have got it done in one go, which is what I had in mind before I started changing my mind, which you can do when it's your own painting and your own style of painting. And what I've realized, and I probably said this in the session of the last series, is that it's enough of a trouble doing the paintings me doing them live is affecting the way I'm doing the painting. And who knows, as I do, if I do more live painting series, what I need to do is get more used to just hitting the live button and painting as I would before. Although even then they start to make me think, what's the point? Because the whole point of doing it live is that I can explain as I'm going along. That's just an underpainting. That's enough of that. Clean the br oh hang on, I'm cleaning the brush on the same bit of kitchen roll that I've used for the to wipe the palette knife. That's no good. I think I can afford to go on to a second bit of kitchen roll. Right. Oh yeah. Oh. Okay. Now I'm getting into it now. It doesn't take long for me to, once I get started into a painting, it doesn't take long for me to get into it. Some of that. Now this colour scheme is one that I've done before, and it's spring, because it has felt a bit spring, I was going to say springy, a bit spring-like at times this week, and it's mild today. So this is going to be another version of a spring painting that I've done twice before. I haven't gotten to hand at the moment. Oh, hang on, I have. Oh, hang on. Right, I'll show you that in a minute. Right, let me show you. That was the first version. I did that in spring 2020 with old paints as I was just getting into sort of this new regime of painting, which I then used to as an experiment to get done on a canvas panel board, sorry, a printed canvas. I then did that painting again the following year, which, and that's what I haven't got to hand. So that's the colour scheme that I'm going for with this. Underpainting, and the other reason I'm doing this underpainting is because it's going to give me a nice little guide of when I'm putting the heavier paint over the top. Yeah, that's exactly what I want, just a nice guide. It's actually looking quite nice by itself, isn't it? Quite like that. I don't do it that often. I should do a bit more of it. This sort of brush stroking, a nice and loose style, you can get some good blending going on. I should have go a bit further. No, why not? Got the paint. And again, as usual, when I do them, I think, oh, I must do more of those. I can think of a few different colour schemes. And I never get round to it because I've got too many ideas. Oh, I've always had too many ideas. But the best way to deal with too many ideas is to just try one of them, see what happens, and then move on to the next, because you're not going to get them done any quicker than doing it like that, one at a time. It's all you can do. Or you can get paralyzed into thinking I've got too much to do and end up doing none of it. That's not good. Right, what's next? Pale green. Ooh, I need to order some pale green, because all I've got is one little tube left. Oh, I do need to. Oh, hang on. I think I might have already ordered some. I've got to order some more of that, because this is just the underpaint, and I've got to put the actual paint on top. That could probably have gone a bit. Probably gone a bit darker. Never mind. Well, by the way, if you do happen to be seeing this live, I can't see any comments because I've got the camera set up the other way, so I'm on the wrong side. Let me have a quick look, see if there's any. I can't see any comments. Oh, quite liking this. Get it darker, bring some of the brown down. Not too much of it, because it is supposed to be green. Oh, I know, I need a bit more green over here. I need a lot more. I said this was supposed to be a guide. It hasn't guided me that well. It's gone. Well, this is a good reason to do the guide. Okay, it's almost one of the, you've got to look at it as a fun way of painting, is when you do something, or you've got something in mind, but when you actually start painting, it goes off in a different direction. That's probably because of lack of skill, more than anything else. making it up as I go along.